Hey guys, it's Biendeo. Welcome back to Legend of Heroes, Trails in the Sky. In the last part, we went through a long exec prologue, and I did a dumb voice for a long time. But now, we are in the Roland sewers. And I gotta do more voices. There appears to be a recovery point set up over there. Let's use it if our HP and EP become low before engaging in any further battles. Oh. So yeah. So, these things, you can basically just use these and you can rest. They're nice healing points. They don't appear too frequently though. Sounds like a plan to me! They don't appear too frequently, so don't get your hopes up too much. We can use this to basically heal Estelle's HP and EP because they're not actually at full. Anyway, this game, encounters are similar to Earthbound. They're on the field, and if you encounter them from behind, you actually get like a free hit. Of course, if they get you from the behind, they get a free hit on you. But the combat's a little different. And it'll be a bit more interesting to look at. Monsters at 12 o'clock. Be careful not to let them take advantage of your blindside. Got it. Yeah, basically. Now, you also can't see monsters from too far away on the field. You can't just see them all the time. But here we go. By the way, freaking love this battle music so much. But now we're actually getting into combat. Now, this game, I've actually not played any strategy RPGs, like, similar to this. I think Disgaea and other games like that are kind of similar. But, what this game is, basically, is it's a grid-based kind of... It's not too hugely strategy. Fields are very small, like, it's just within this kind of square area. But, there's so much depth to this combat. It's excellent. I love it. So anyway, so we can attack, and we can attack anyone who's within our little ring here. We can also move to any of these spaces that are in the blue. And of course, we can just hit this guy right here for a nice good 45 health. The guy at the far end is a bit too far, but that's okay. Now, there's also a turn order going on in the top or on the left side of the screen, I guess. These guys are actually really bad and they're not even attacking. The dirty rats as well. And you can see the HP and elemental efficacy. I think that's just the efficacy and not efficiency. Once we get into using more magic abilities, you'll be able to see how that plays out. Now, you can also hit attack, and you can just kind of automatically move towards a target without actually putting yourself... just kind of efficiently moving yourself to a target. Can we kill him? Hey, we did it! So that was easy enough. Freaking 50 minutes of dialogue and... that, basically. Now, these enemies also drop a bit of Sepeth. We'll be collecting Sepeth throughout the game. Ooh, duty bone. Sweet. We can actually see that in our items as well. The tier bombs, by the way, I believe are healing. Why is the descriptions not coming up? Alright, I just kind of restarted the game and this is back. I don't know why it wasn't there. So yeah, so our tier bombs heal 200 health, which is a lot more than we've got right now. We can also look up the monster guide, and that lets you see any enemy that you've encountered, basically. You can see information about it, but you can't see the stats just yet. We'll get into that a little bit later, but what's kind of nice is that you can see pretty much all the stats about enemies as well as items they have. For example, we got a juicy bone, which is an ingredient. By the way, ingredients, there is a lovely cooking kind of side thing you can do. Ooh. Ooh. Here comes some more! Depending on the enemy, some physical attacks may be ineffective. Let's use arts, not physical attacks. Okay! So, yeah, so certain attacks aren't actually as good with physical attacks. They may also be very good at attacking you close up, so keep a bit of distance and you can use arts from where you're standing as opposed to where you're, as opposed to moving up to them. So, because we've got airstrike, that's not really anything. We'll use airstrike. Now, here's the thing with arts, is that every single one of them is a charge-up. So you're gonna need to spend a little bit of time charging up your attack. Fortunately, these guys are just being nice and being tutorial and just sitting tight for us. Now, I've put the game on the hard difficulty as well, so I might have a bit of trouble, but the PC version of this game, which, by the way, is the superior version, if you do want it on the go, the PSP version is nice, but the PC version adds a couple of extra features, one of which is probably one of the best things, and even if you've never played an RPG, I would recommend playing this game because of this feature. If we go to the options of the game, we've got a thing called retry offset. And what this actually does is that every time you die, it makes the battle slightly easier. And it will basically accommodate harder enemies for you. With this, they've designed the game so that it's actually kind of tough. This is a tough game. Especially if you're not grinding. If you do grind, you'll alleviate a bit. But you don't need to grind because of this feature. Estelle, let's try using crafts this time around. Since crafts have other effects besides just dealing out damage, they're worth a shot. Roger that! So, crafts are basically the abilities of each character. Now, you can't set crafts. They're just based on the character. But what's cool about crafts is that they're all quite interesting. So I can use this one. And also, they're immediate, so don't worry. I can use this and it'll buff our strengths. And then I can use Joshua's one called Jolt Strike. Like Advance Wars, which basically attacks twice. With the bonus strength increase, makes this fight a bit easier. But now we're taking damage. Oh boy. Now, crafts, by the way, do use CP, which are craft points. Easy. Craft points are actually gotten by doing damage. You also get a little bit by taking damage. It does recover, of course, by taking damage, and, generally, your craft attacks are very nice, but there is a very good reason why you may want to wait until your craft points build up all the way, and we'll get into that once I talk about it. We just got a, reviving bomb, which is, why is my text gone? Come on, game. And now it's back. Okay. I'm going crazy. I'm going insane, apparently. This heals 100 HP and revives. It's a revive, basically. We also got some crisp onions and a curative horn. Again, more crafting, more cooking materials. It's a door, rust the door. Anyway, here's the dude. Roar. Oh, what a surprise, another creepy thing. I just wish there was an easier way to take care of them. One blow using an S-Craft or S-Break should do the trick for just about any enemy. The catch is our CV has to be at least 100 to pull off one of those moves. Well, okay, sweet, you're gonna just say it, alright. So the best part about S-Crafts is that they are used immediately. There's no build up on them. And the effect of them is called an S-Break. It's like a limit break. No, it's basically a limit break. So we can use... in fact, they've even given us some CP just so that it's built up. What we can do is that we can do a bit of a starting attack, and that builds it up. So now, once the bar has become 100, you can unleash the S-Break. You can, by the way, you can trigger this at any time. Provided it doesn't have the little slash through it. So, in the middle of this attack, you can go over and select this, and then BAM! You give yourself the S-Craft turn, and most of these S-Crafts can be used on any single enemy in the entire field. By the way, the battles are the only time when you're gonna hear actual voice acting from characters. Every character does have voice acting, which is nice. I've kind of done good. Oh, stuff you! The S-Crafts are cool, though. And I love the strategy of just kind of being able to chuck them whenever you build them up. It's a nice strategy. And in fact, that's the thing. This is basically... This game might not be one of the deepest strategy games out there, but it's so accessible, and I really... It's great for people who just aren't interested in the genre. Because I swear, like, if you're not into RPGs, you might still like this game. Oh, we got an enemy. So that's the treasure chest we're after, huh? If we've made it this far, then the rest is gonna be a piece of cake. Seems like we've just got a little breathing room at least. Let's pay close attention to our battle order this time. There should be a number of ways to get more mileage out of our actions. So yeah, so you can do extra things to help your team and play around with the turn order. Especially because we got quite a few enemies going on here. There's also bonuses that happen on each turn, and you may want to lean towards some of these as well. Whoever the icon's on is the person who gets that ability. So you've got healing here, you've got Sepeth up, which gives more Sepeth if you were to take out an enemy. Do we have an easy way of taking out an enemy? We might use Airstrike. Okay, maybe not this turn. We'll use Soul Blur on this dude back here. Now they're going a little bit easy on us, as of course the healing is like. Oh, he's going in. So this guy gets bonus Sepeth. I don't know if enemies reduce the Sepeth that you like have, like it actually takes it off. Is that enough for a kill? Oh, sick, that's like dead on. All right. Now here's one thing you may want to be worried about a little bit. Just a heads up that Arts always uses an extra turn, which is bad because I was about to let him die, and he was probably going to die if I tried actually healing him with the Arts ability. This is why you'd use the item, is because at least the item you can use in one go. Problem with the item is that you have to move next to whoever you're using it on, or on yourself if you want. This guy's just chilling in the back, he doesn't mind. Now, I believe... Oh, this isn't... Oh, the guy at the top's gonna get the health. He doesn't need it. We're gonna make a run. We're gonna make a run to him. Can I just say, I love this battle music. It's amazing, it's great. And after freaking 50 hours? This game took me 50 hours. And I wonder if this run is going to be even longer. I'm familiar with the game, but I'm going to be reading out the text, so who knows. Sepeth up, you know what that means? More Sepeth. Sweet. I guess. You actually get Sepeth up just for hitting an enemy as opposed to just defeating. So we got more experience. Crispy onions and some horn and some bone. Sweet. What's in the box? What's in the box? What's in the box today? Two boxes. Well, that's weird. There's a couple of boxes inside the treasure chest. The fact that there's not just one, but two is kind of interesting, too. Wonder what's inside. Remember, Estelle, our mission is to search and retrieve only. I'm pretty sure looking inside those boxes doesn't fall inside our mission objective. You're no fun at all, Joshua. This has nothing to do with our mission. It's what I like to call good, honest curiosity. You know, we're the only ones down here. We can get away with a teensy-weensy peek, right? If you feel like flunking today's test, then by all means, be my guest. Did you just say the F word? Yup, opening one of those boxes could result in an automatic fail for the both of us. If this were a real job, the contents of those boxes would belong to the client, and as long as they were nothing illegal, we would have no right to open them. I know, you're right, Joshua, but I just can't help myself. If you absolutely have to know what's inside, why not ask Miss Shara when we get back? But for now, we need to focus on getting out of here. Alright, alright. So that's good. I believe there's another treasure chest somewhere down here. Is it up here? I'm done. Also, by the way, talk to every treasure chest afterwards. You're gonna get some repeating dialogue, but stuff like this. It's beautiful. I love it. This game's great. You gotta remember, talk to the treasure chest. You flunk! Just kidding. It's great. I love it. I got nothing but praise for this game, apart from maybe it's not as, like, in-depth as other games. But, like, that's comparative. That's comparative criticism. It's not the fairest thing to be asking about. And so, we can just go out of here. So, it took 14 minutes to do this, and I had, like, a 46-minute cutscene beforehand. Good work, you two. As a rule of training, I'm going to need to confirm the items in your possession. Yup, they're the real deal, alright. I don't see any evidence of tampering, either. Oof, that was a close one. I figured she would try and set us up like that. Congratulations to the both of you. You have successfully passed your qualification test. You didn't really think something like that simple would be a problem for us, did you? So, Shara, what's in those boxes you had us get? That's for me to know and you to find out after your training is finished. That's enough chit-chat for now, so let's get back to work. You two still have some things left to do. Seriously? But didn't you just say that we passed the test? You still have to learn about how to report the results of your work. I'm aware that you're both tired, but this is no time to shirk your duties. Let's get back to the guild. When is this day going to be over? Oh well, no sense in giving up when the finish line is in sight. Agreed, it seems like we're within reaching distance of our goal. Your final training is how to report to the guild. Whenever you finish a job, it is your duty to report the results of your work to the guild. Reporting how you resolved the situation and the steps you took to get there are all part of your job as a bracer. You can report your results to the front desk in each guild branch, and as you already know by now, Aino is in charge here at the Rolling Branch. In addition, this is where you will be paid for your work.
I look forward to seeing great things from the both of you. Now that we're here, why don't you go ahead and report the results of today's training?
So you can... In order to fully finish a quest, you have to report it in. Oh, to this person, by the way. Anyway, receive payment. There you go. And you got a BP. We're still 9th class, but alright.
Good job, you two. It seems like you were able to complete your objective without running into any major problems. Another thing to take note of is that depending on how you handle a job, you may see an increase or decrease in the amount of pay you receive. When you report the results of your work to the guild, pay is in the form of mirror isn't the only thing you receive. You also accumulate points, which are known as bracer points. Bracer points are an indication of your achievements as a bracer. When these points exceed a certain value, you will advance in rank as a bracer and be rewarded with a special piece of equipment that's special... Special by the special guild. The ranks of the junior bracers start at 9 and go all the way up to 1. Please set your sights on making first rank and work hard. The amount of mirror and BP you receive will be also recorded in your bracer notebooks, so please have a look sometime later on. All that's left to do now is finalize your training. Let's head back upstairs, shall we? I'll talk to you later, Anna, and sorry about putting more work on your plate today than usual. Don't worry about it. Training new bracers is important for the future of the guild. I fully intend to work these two to the bone in any case. To the bone? And knowing Shara, it will involve the whip. Let me say it again. Good work, you two. You now have officially completed the entire training course. From now on, you will be learning from your own real-world experience. Well then.
Charizard holds up two small boxes.
Aren't these the boxes the ones? In answer to your question, yes, these are the boxes you retrieved during today's test. You seem awfully curious to find out what's inside, Estelle. Are you saying that it's okay if we open them? That's right. Why don't the both of you have a look and see what's inside? Sweet!
Alright, let's have a look. Estelle and Joshua open the boxes to find a junior bracer emblem.
This crest is...
So does that mean that we're... Ahem.
Estelle Bright, Joshua Bright, beginning this day at 1500 hours, you are both hereby appointed as junior bracers within the Bracer Guild. From here on, you will work as members of the Bracer Guild to support the livelihood of those around you, defend peace, and uphold justice. Congratulations, you two, and welcome into the fold. Did you hear that, Joshua? We become members of the Bracer Guild!
So I'm a bracer now, huh? I think the realization is only now just beginning to sink in.
Come on, Joshua, you should be jumping for joy or running around and screaming at the top of your lungs like this. Look at us now, world, we did it!
I was happy until you made my eardrums bleed.
I hate to interrupt the celebrations, Estelle, but I need to take off now. I have some backed up work that needs my immediate attention. We understand you have been spending a lot of extra hours working with us and during this busy time for the guild. Before you head out, Shara, I just wanted to say thanks.
Likewise, I appreciate all the trouble that you've gone through for us, Shara.
Don't mention it, training new recruits is one of the Bracer's many duties. Believe it or not, I was once in your shoes a long time ago when your father, Cassius, trained me. So that's why you have so much respect for my dad, huh? There's actually much more to it than that, but I'll save that conversation for another day. As for the both of you, work hard to become full-fledged Bracers early on so that you can help guide those new recruits who come after yourselves. And in time, I hope to see you both become respectable Bracers like your father. Anyway, I'll leave you with that thought.
Alright. See ya.
I just don't get it.
Get what?
This is Charizard, aka the Silver Streak, one of the most skilled young bracers we're talking about. So why is it that she holds Dad in such high esteem? He just seems like nothing more than a no-good middle-aged man who is always out doing who knows what instead of being a father.
A no-good middle-aged man, huh? From your viewpoint, it doesn't come as a surprise that you would see him in that fashion.
Huh?
Never mind. Let's hurry and head home. We should let Dad know that we're qualified as junior bracers.
Right!
So that's great! Now, there's a couple... Oh, my mouse was on screen. Oh. Ooh.
Hurry up and come on! Wait for me, Luke! Huh? Oh, it's you two. Oh, great, it's Estelle. Hi there, Joshua! Okay, you little twerp, what's with the "oh great, it's Estelle" remark? And what's the big hurry? How about telling us where you're headed? You're not thinking of wandering out of town alone, are you? The roads are full of monsters, I hope you know. You're such a pest, Estelle. Don't you know that there's no room for girls to be sticking their big fat noses in boys' business? Quit acting like you're a bracer, you wannabe. How wrong you are, Luke. How incredibly wrong. You're more wrong than a fool who thinks there's better tasting milk in Libel than the milk that comes from the Purcell farm. What? No way. You're full of it, Estelle. In fact, as of just a few minutes ago, we are qualified to become real bracers. Are you hearing what I'm saying? Real bracers!
More like braces and training, really. Don't think you should be getting on your high horse just yet, Estelle. Now a high pony, on the other hand.
Quit being a killjoy. Wow, you two are great. I'm so happy for the both of you. Oh, Pat, you're such a good little boy. Unlike that smart-eyed and cynical brat you call a friend. This isn't fair. I was supposed to become a bracer first. I can accept that Joshua became a bracer before me, but getting passed by the likes of Estelle? What's the likes of Estelle supposed to mean? Just so you know, you can't even be a bracer until you're 16 years old. Get it? Only mature people allowed. And that means no little kids who are still going to Sunday school.
I don't know how I should put this, Estelle, but Sunday school is dying to have you back.
You better watch out, Estelle. I'm going to train at my secret base, and before you know it, I'm going to be a bracer too. Come on, Pat, let's go.
Alright, I'm coming. See you later, Estelle. Bye, Joshua.
That boy Luke, he's always trying to pick a fight with me. I wonder if he just plain hates me or something.
Rather, I think it's the exact opposite.
What do you mean by that?
Don't worry about it. It's just a boy thing. At any rate, what do you think Luke meant when he said the secret base? I don't know why, but somehow it makes me a bit curious.
I know exactly what you mean. A secret base sounds really intriguing. The pure heart of a young child can be so inspiring at times.
That's not really what I meant by curious. Alright, so anyway, there's a couple of things that we need to do here. Most importantly, you gotta go into the general store. Hey there, Estelle and Joshua. How can I help you? Did you manage to become bracers?
You bet we did. Maybe I should have you start calling me Hyper Bracer Estelle from now on.
By the way, Mr. Renum, did the Libel news come in? Yeah, it came in a little afternoon.
Don't brush me off like that, you two. Oh, whatever, I'll take one copy then.
It comes to 100 mirror, please.
I know my dad always buys a copy of this magazine, but does it really sell that well?
It sure does. The Liberal News has an excellent reporter and camerawoman who have done a great job reporting the latest and most reliable news. They're even supposed to have a running story related to Queen Alicia's birthday celebration. One more thing before you go. This gift is my way of saying congratulations. It's a free sample item I received with my shipment of goods, but don't hold the free part against me.
Hey, it's a recipe book. What's this supposed to be for? There's a ton of blank pages.
It's a recipe book, isn't it?
Oh my gosh, recipe book!
You got it. When you get hurt fighting, if you just limit yourself to healing bombs all the time, it's gonna cut pretty deep into your wallets. This is where a recipe book comes into play. If you eat food to recover your strength instead, it's basically free. Assuming you have all the ingredients anyway. So if you eat something new, write down what's in it, and you'll have lots of recipes in no time. So how about we try this out? Go ahead and eat this cookie, Estelle. That is not a very good thing you should be trusting someone with.
Well, I have made it a personal rule to never turn down sweets.
So when you eat something, you learn its recipe. Somehow, Estelle is a culinary genius and can detect the ingredients of food by eating it. That's amazing. And writing it down as well, knowing how to make something just by eating it. Basically, all you have to do is eat the food to learn the recipe. It's as simple as that. As you're traveling about, you should eat whatever food you come across that you haven't had an opportunity to try before. Well, that sounds pretty convenient.
It's not that I don't like cooking and all, it's just that I never seem to get any better. I'd sure love to be able to increase my repertoire and really shock my dad's taste buds for once in my life.
That's the spirit. And in passing, if you're in need of any ingredients, I'd be delighted to service your cooking needs.
You really know how to solicit your customers, Mr. Renon.
Thank you for the recipe book. We'll put it to good use. Now, by the way, that's a heads up. Grab recommended dishes at restaurants or to-go meals, because then you can learn how to make them as well as being able to buy them. You're gonna need to find these foods at some way. Also, some foods are marked as sit-down, which means you have to eat them at certain spots. Other than that, yeah, you can get ingredients. Some monsters have ingredients, and in fact, that's what half of this is for. Junior Bracer album. So this is our recipe book. As you can see, there's a lot of recipes. And we've learned the maple cookie, which we need fresh milk, milled flour, and maple sugar. But what's great is that it heals 80 health. It's nice and easy, and it's probably a bit cheaper than other materials. Now we can also...
By the way, Mr. Marina, how do you know that today was our last day of training?
Haha, in a certain sense, both of you and Joshua are like celebrities here in Roland. I tend to hear a lot from customers coming through here.
I shouldn't have expected anything less from Roland. The grapevine around here is seriously something to be reckoned with.
No kidding, the women here especially love to gossip. So we can talk to him, and he sells lots of ingredients. But he doesn't exactly sell any, thingo. So in order for the maple cookie, we need fresh milk, milled flour, and Eggs? Was it eggs? No. Maple sugar. Yeah. So in total, that comes to 58 mirror, which for an 80 healing item is a little bit better than a 200 for a 200. Maybe not the best in battle, but definitely it's something to look for. So we got that. Now, I think I did this last part and I jumped the gun here. We can head in here.
Really? You're completely finished with your training? Yeah, we're finished, Elisa. I am officially a real bracer. Well, congratulations, Estelle. You've always wanted to be a bracer ever since you were a kid, haven't you, Estelle? But don't bracers have a lot of dangerous jobs? Yeah, something like that. Joshua and Estelle, don't overdo it. And watch out for each other. Estelle has this tendency to get in over her head.
That's a pretty good observation, Elisa. The only problem is that Estelle doesn't realize this herself.
I'm standing right here, you guys. Joshua and I just care about you, Estelle, that's all. Anyway, don't get too full of yourself and end up getting hurt, okay? Okay, okay.
So we can come in here and what we can do is we can buy the wholesome pasta, which eats it, but we learn the recipe. I jumped the gun last time without the recipe book. So we can go here. Now, wholesome pasta is a sit-down food, which means you have to eat it as you craft it. You can't eat it, you can't turn it into an item. So the wholesome pasta though, milled flour is actually very cheap. Beast flesh, I don't think you can buy though. You have to find it. But 180 health is a much more bulky thing, of course. Now, there's no inventory limit as well, so don't worry about that. Also, here's a map of the world. There was a town map in our inventory the whole time. Basically, there's 5 different regions of the game, and each of the 5 chapters of the game will take place in each region. So there's not a lot of backtracking. You can back up all the way to a previous region, but in general, everything's basically isolated in for each region. Now the only thing, we can read the Liberal News issue 1. Half year countdown to Her Majesty Queen Alicia's 60th birthday celebration has begun. This has been a banner year for Her Royal Highness, sparking more anticipation than this event has ever seen before. But we must not forget too, since this year is the 10th since the Hundred Days War, a period of intense turmoil for all of Liberal. As we celebrate, let us also reflect on the tragedies of the past, so that we may refrain from ever reliving them in the future. We may have been afforded this luxury of hindsight, and we must use it to its fullest. Main Street is filled with the bustle of men and women furiously preparing decor and merchandise for the upcoming festivities and developing new products specifically for the sale during the celebration. The competition is truly cutthroat. I yearn for my customers' taste buds to sing with delight, says Mrs. Sorbet, local ice cream purveyor who deals her wares in the city's east block. Sadly, her new menu will remain a mystery to us until the day of the festival. As the population grows, more and more businesses pop up all around me, but all that means is more customers, especially at festival time, so I'm certainly not complaining, she explains with a sly smile. Miss Sorbet seems to have a few tricks up her sleeves, so to all her competitors, we say watch out. Prior to the festival, Her Majesty will be hosting our annual martial arts competition in the Royal Arena. This fiercely competitive tournament is always a big hit, with some avid spectators even regarding it as the day's main event. Which team will come up on top? According to our sources, the Bose region has seen a string of burglaries over the last several days, and the people have had enough. The Royal Army Border Patrol stationed at the Haken Gate has been stepping up efforts to apprehend the group of criminals responsible for their acts, and anyone with information on their identities is urged to contact the Border Patrol immediately. And the Kingfisher Inn, along with a beautiful Valeria Lakeshore, is more popular than ever following a visit from the women of the Royal City. Won't you come and fish with us too? There's some nice stuff in there. There's several of these liberal issues, and I recommend trying to find all these. I will be trying my hardest. So, there's one last thing, and that is, I believe we can go into this. Well, okay, we're not going out there. We're not getting off that easy. If we go in here, head up these stairs. Nope. I believe. Or was that? No, it wasn't this. Nope. Perhaps it's in this guy. Thanks to the airline, as in recent days, even Roland has been able to get a good selection of books, and thanks to that, I find myself compelled to buy a new one each time I head to the store. But I get yelled at my wife for getting so many, so maybe I should cut back a bit. I've only got the first chapter of this novel, so if you want, I'll give it to you. So we got Carnelia, chapter 1, which we're gonna read as well. Oh boy, this one's a long one. I stood there, upright in front of the revolving door, scuffing the heels of my boots against the ground. Pulling slightly on the collar of my trench coat, I dropped my chin and gazed at my partial reflection in the curved glass. Aside from my short, cropped hair, I wore a modest-looking double-breasted leather raincoat and a pair of special-order steel-reinforced boots, both of which at first glance appeared to be the most common of common apparel. Yet they were, in fact, much more than the naked eye could detect. My ordinary, average appearance, it was of just as much importance today as it had been on any other day in times past. Not far off, the sound of footfalls echoed rhythmically like the steady beat of a pendulum swinging back and forth as the throngs of those coming and going moved quickly along the cobblestone avenue, enveloped and tinged silver by the morning mist. At times, the calling voice of a street peddler disrupted the steady flow, but as soon as the hawking cry faded away, it would resume its course. Each morning that I found myself setting foot in the Imperial City, I also found my surroundings to be unchanged and stained by the same somber tone of grey. Snatching up a magazine from the underarm of a street vendor, I tossed a few mirrors to the left hand poised expectantly behind his back. The Imperial Chronicle, the magazine I read so often that even the ink bleeds were familiar. Roughly flipping open its cover, I scanned the headlines along the top of its monochrome pages. Then suddenly, my breath caught in my throat. At the very bottom of the local news page, I found those letters, that sequence of characters which I had not heard nor seen since the time that the life-changing incident. My eyes instantly gravitated to the spot, and for a time, remained fixated. Ein Selnate. The very meaning of those letters became lost to my senses as I stood motionless, my gaze fixed on the same line of text until it all seemed to coalesce into a single blotch of ink. After a few seconds of blank comprehension, my vision settled and I wrenched my eyes to the beginning of the article. As I began to read, my memories verged on a single point in my past and then slowly started to run in reverse, heading for that fateful event 3 years prior when this name was first introduced to me. It was on an afternoon all those years ago, on a day not unlike this one, where the capital was overshadowed by its typical gloomy aura. I was a little younger than now, a 22-year-old boy who stood silently in front of the boutique door as usual, double-checking his appearance before lightly treading over to Mick's Imperial Factory. It was on this day that it had been arranged for me to receive a new job from Mick, the shop owner himself. Although he was a drab middle-aged man, I, being the urban enthusiast I was, had found myself as one of his few regular customers. I headed down a dank alleyway, and after passing through partially rotted wooden gate, I could see the soft glow of the flickering orbal light just outside the entrance of the factory, whose structure was halfway below the street. I first began receiving jobs from Mish about the time when dissension began to occur in society over the Hundred Days War. It was during this period that relations between the Liberal Kingdom and the Empire were at their worst, and the importation of orphans had become almost non-existent. Conspiring with underground... Oh! I hit B. Great. conspiring with underground elements and planning a smuggling operation, Mitch made me out to be his accomplice in crime, for the job which I had received by his hand was none other than that of the courier. Being nothing more than a commoner in my teens at the time I met him and a juvie devoid of any connections in life besides, I naturally jumped at the opportunity without a moment's hesitation. Yet even after relations with Liberal had returned to some degree of normalcy, I realized I was in no mood to give up my specialty, which focused mainly on the delivery of stolen goods, the reason being there was no job out there which could bring in the kind of mirror this one did. With an unrefined and inconspicuous appearance, I had countless times before hidden items of various sorts in my hat and trousers and made my way hither and thither between the borders of these neighboring nations, and though to my delight, my wallet had become increasingly laden with a bounty of monetary rewards, I had routinely changed my alias as a precautionary measure, so much in fact that these false names had built up into quite a list over the last few years. I'd been known as Phil the Frivolous, Rooney the Trickster, and even Chris the Coward. However, Mish had always called me by one name, Toby. This was the identity I had used for my initial job, and the one I liked above all the others. This is a nice fictional novel. So anyway, with that, let's keep going on, shall we? I don't actually think there's anything too big other than... I think that's it, really. That's all we need to do. Easy enough. Estelle, Joshua, am I glad I found you two? Oh. What's the dealio? Oh, hi, Aina. Is something wrong? You seem to be in quite a hurry. We've got a bit of a problem. Is your father at home today?
Yes, he is. He said something about having to sort out a bunch of documents. But what's going on? You know Luke and Pat, right? Sure we do. In fact, we saw them not that long ago. What's wrong? Are they in some sort of trouble? I don't know how to say this, but I just heard from Uni that Luke and Pat ran off to the tower that lies on the northern outskirts of Roland. You mean the Tower of Esmelas? Isn't that place supposed to be breeding ground for monsters? That's what they say. Unfortunately, at the moment, Sherazard is out on other braids of business, so I want to ask your father to bring the boys home safely. What are you talking about? There's no time for that. Joshua and I will go after them and bring them back. I don't know if that's such a good idea. The two of you only just qualified to be junior braces today.
With all due respect, I believe that Estelle's judgment is correct in this situation. If the two of us hurry, we may even be able to catch up with the boys before they reach the tower.
I understand. I will take responsibility for what happens. As an emergency request from the Bracer Guild, I ask that you lose no time in bringing about the safe return of these children. Roger that!
Understood.
The Esmelas Tower can be reached by taking the western path at the junction along the Malga Trail. You can get onto the Malga Trail through Roland's Northwest Gate. I'll be on standby at the Guild, so if you run into any trouble, you know where to find me.
This is our first real job. Come on, Joshua, we don't have any time to lose.
I'm right behind you. Okay, so we're not done just now. We still gotta keep going, but that's okay. So the, what was it, the Malga Trail? Is that it? Hello.
Yeah.
By the way, with the controls, you can hit the, I've set it so my shoulder buttons are 45 degree angle turns, but I've also got it so the right stick just kind of moves the camera automatically. Or freely like that. So we can head north to the Malga Trail. Now this is, an area, as you can see, the enemies don't quite appear as quickly as you'd want them to. But that's okay. We've taken a preemptive attack here. Now, bonus points, this is a critical hit. It's set by the move. There's no random criticals. It's just set by the turn order. Now these enemies are flying felines. Actually, they're a little bit weak to, elementals. As you can see, they're 120% rather than 100, which means they're a little bit more effective than otherwise. Now, fortunately, I don't think... Actually, time's okay. Now, while there are seven types of arts, it only kind of lists four. Those are kind of the four main ones, though. You'll see the other ones around, but get the crit and get that extra strength. That's beautiful. Yeah. Beast flesh. We're gonna keep going through here. By the way, you can ignore enemies. Because it's Earthbound style and they're just kind of sitting tight, you don't have to fight them. So let's keep going. We got this dude here. This little flowery dude. Look at him booping about. Now, as you can see, if we had fired elemental, then it would be great for us to use it. We don't though. Can't do anything about it. But what we can do is we can use an art, because the good thing about arts is that there's no range to them. You can use them from way across the map, so we could rely on this guy to come up at us, basically. Or he could be cheap and shoot us like that. Oh my gosh, I just realized Estelle's health. By the way, just as a thing, different arts also take different amounts of time. The healing ones in general are a bit quicker to use. So you can rely on being able to use them and then maybe getting to use them immediately afterwards. Also, just as a heads up, you can go into your augment, you can actually select some abilities and use them just on the go. So we can use that on Estelle right now, which is nice. Estelle's got way more EP as well, so I recommend using her as the healer. But you can technically use any augment on whatever character. By the way, we've also got equipment. We haven't even gotten into the whole equipment stage, like, we haven't even, freaking gotten different kinds of equipment, but holy crap, this is a nice equipment system going on. We'll fight this dude as well. Gotta get some more battles. That jazz and music, man. Can never get over it. We've nearly built up the thingo. There we go, let's use it just right away. Now, you can also use the S-break on your turn if you want to. And you're not forced to use it immediately. Just as a heads up, the CP bar will keep going past 100 up to 200. If you use your S-break at any point during like during this, then it will go down basically. It'll... So I could use it just here. So if I were to use it like at 150, it would go back down to zero. But if you build it up to 200, you may get a much stronger attack. Maybe. I can't remember if you can get it right away, or whether it's like if you could use it right now, or whether you have to learn it later on. More beast flesh. Alright. So we're gonna keep making our way through it. We got more flower, dude. Actually, I'm gonna be a little bit smart here, and we're gonna equip the fire one. Now, evade gives you a bit of agility, which does not make you... I believe agility lets you move further per turn. But we can equip attack. Now, attack actually makes us a little bit more vulnerable, but that's okay, because I'll just equip it for this one battle in particular. Oh, there's two of them, even better. I'm actually going to use Clock Up on Estelle here. What this does is it actually makes her a little bit more faster. Now, don't use all your EP in one go. I'm seeing the hard difficulty kick in. By the way, if a character can't use it on their target, they'll just kind of end up using it on themselves. Just as a heads up, you can always run. Running is always an option. The problem with running is, you don't get the experience. You probably just wasted stuff. Like, there's zero reason to fight. But here's the thing, of course, is that you need to fight enemies in order to level up. That's just a small... Oh, yeah. Is there any way we can heal? Apart from, the inn? There we go. Now, I'm gonna spend 20 mirror at the end, but it's okay. You can also trade a septum, by the way, here. What this does, by the way, is that you can actually go to here and you can up it, and you'll get, as it says on the side there, I'll get 8 mirror for every single earth septum I give, 10 for every wind one. Depending on the place, you'll get different amounts of mirror, so just let yourself know that you'll always be able to get stuff, get money. It's not too hard to get money in this game. Oh, see ya. How about I just kind of ignore that one, dude? I'll just keep fighting the cats instead. Augment. Keep it on the evade, or even better, defense. No, I think I'm good. We'll fight this cat dude again. Just so that we can get a level up on this part. Also, build up that CP just so that when a boss comes, you're very focused. You got that move available. I don't know why I'm not using abilities. Why I'm not using arts here. Yeah, I think it'd be better just use the art. There you go. Oh, that was a solid sun. I may as well take him out. The feline's got a charge going on, so I'm a little worried. Kitty kick! Ah! Jeez. Alright. Jeez, enemies are kicking my butt here. Maybe that's the hard difficulty for me. This game also has a New Game Plus mode, so you can keep going straight from the beginning once you beat the game. But we'll get into that a bit later. Anyway, let's heal up. It's here. I don't think I need to use it on Joshua just now. See ya. See ya, felines. This dude's chilling out. But we got a little chest here. A reviving bomb. Not a thing remains in the chest except a lonely dead spider. Aw. Poor spider. Didn't even see it coming. Now, we got one sign here. We got the Malgamine over there, and then we've also got the Esmela's Tower just here. Now we can... You can actually try to go to the Malgamine. Eh. Let's not. Okay, sneak in through here. Is it here? Oh no, it's back up there. Gotta check that map. Get that preemptive strike. So what the preemptive strike does is that we can just kind of use our abilities and they're just straight here. The strength up, by the way, only applies to that turn. See, we've even got like, we can even use another attack right after this. That's the beauty of the preemptive strikes. I think I'll actually use a physical attack from Joshua here just because he's got his little strength up here. Yeah, nice. So it does 70 damage. And then we'll use an attack here. Bam. So hopefully now you guys are getting a bit of a hang of how the gameplay works. Ooh, so close to a level. Getting Mirror, of course, is always good. I recommend saving it, though. Don't use it unless you really need money. Gotta fight them cats. Dude, I hate the flowers, man. Alright, this is definitely gonna be enough for a level up, but... Ooh, strength up. Nice. Sweet. That's good. We're getting there. We're getting there, don't you worry. Hit him with an attack. He's next. There you go. Sweet, we got the limit break. I mean the S break, not the limit break. I'll go for it. Oh, I'm taking another hit. Oh no. That's good. So what's also kind of interesting is that enemies also have arts and crafts. Wait a minute. Let's move out. Anyway, enough chatter. We got a level up, sweet. Now, level ups will get you abilities or buff your stats. It gives you full healing as well. By the way, I'm just going to save. Also, if you're wondering why I'm starting at 300, it's because my main playthrough went all the way to 266. And now you know I played this just over a year ago. Ah. But we're going to save here. We're not ending the part off just yet. If we keep going. Dun dun dun.
It looks like we've come all the way to the Esmela's Tower. I didn't see any sign of them along the trail, so do you think they've wandered inside?
It's quite likely that's the case. Let's go in, it looks like we'll need to hurry.
Right.
See ya. It seems that I forgot to even get this chest as I went around here. It's got a tear bomb. I wonder whose fault that is. I acknowledge it. Oh, crap. Oh, jeez. That was my bad. I'm hoping that us not being on full health is not going to be a huge concern. That being said, of course, if we die, it just makes it easier for us. And that's... It's basically Let's Player mode, because the last thing I want is to be forever stuck on a boss. That was something I was really worried about Final Fantasy VII. Unfortunately, this game making it easier, but I will count my deaths. We'll give myself a death counter. So now we're up in Esmela's Tower.
It's dark in here. I'm scared. Quit being a baby. We're only on the first floor of this place. Did you hear that? They really did come in here.
Estelle, you're right.
Look, Pat. If you can hear me, answer now. Those little brats, are they pretending they can't hear me?
They might have climbed up to the second floor. Let's hurry and see if we can find them. Now, you will find several places in the game kind of similar looking to this place, but this one's probably the easiest of them all to navigate, mainly because there was nothing on the first floor.
What are you gonna do? Somebody help! Let's go, Joshua! Right, I got your back. You must just go somewhere else. No, shoo, leave us alone. Chew on this!
Bam. Bam.
Estelle, what are you doing here? Joshua, you're here too. Get back, you two. These monsters aren't playing around.
We'll take care of them. So we got a kind of boss battle going on, but what's going on is that now we've got two NPCs here. Basically, if either of them die, you lose. So pro tip, don't let them die. Here's the annoying thing. They're going to be chilling out. They're also going to be screwing up with your strength up abilities. Here's something to note. This has got plus times 50 strengths, which means this is absolutely going to kill this dude. By far. And we can use Airstrike on this dude, which is probably not enough, but it's good. Let's see, I got the crit on this dude, so I think it would be wiser to use the Jewel Strike on this dude. Because you get two crits. It's good. And that was the guy who was attacking next as well, which was convenient. I'm a little worried that Estelle's gonna die, so I'm gonna use a tear on her. See what I mean about how it lets you use it a lot quicker? Her turn order also came in a bit quicker as well. I gotta watch out for the health, but shouldn't be too bad. Give him a little 1-2. Bam. Easy. Sweet. That was it. Easy enough. I like how the next level is even quicker to get. Alright.
It looks like that's that.
Yeah, I'm glad everyone's safe too. By the way, that was great timing the way you blitzed those monsters, Estelle.
You really think so? Is it safe now? Oh man, that was awesome!
Oh.
You really showed them, Estelle. Not bad for a girl. You little twerp! Ow, that hurts. What are you trying to do to me? What's wrong with you? You even dragged poor Pat all the way up here against his will.
Oh.
It's time to think about what you did today. Ow, you're hurting me. Stop it. I should stop it, you violent she-devil. So this is the thanks I get for saving your neck, huh? Looks like it's time to give you some of my special discipline. Ow, whoa. Alright, Estelle, I'm sorry. Everything was all my fault. Estelle? Shouldn't we forgive each other like they teach at school? This brat doesn't need forgiveness, but a little discipline should do the trick. Estelle, behind you. It's something with teeth, isn't it?
Oh.
Nice monster? I'm not gonna make it in time.
Oh.
Ooh. Huh? Dad, you came!
You still lack skill and understanding, Estelle. You must always prepare for unseen danger by sharpening your senses. That's part of what it means to be a bracer.
Dad, what are you doing here?
I just happened to be in town and heard the whole story from Aina. I'll give you points for your quick thinking and taking action to come after the children, but you failed to follow through completely.
I really messed up, didn't I? It's a good thing you showed up when you did. I'm sorry, I should have been watching her back.
That just means that you have room for improvement. Constantly working to overcome your weak spots is the key.
Understood.
So how about we head home, everyone? Can you boys walk?
I think so. That was incredible, Mr. Bright. You were like a gazillion times more awesome than Estelle.
Of course I was. I'm her father. Alright, everyone, let's file on out of here.
I'm with you, Mr. Bright.
Alright, sweet.
Who's the glory hog now? I mean, I guess I should be thankful that Dad saved my behind. But why does he have to go and take all the credit like that? It really chaps my hide!
That's just the way he is. After all, he is Cassius Bright.
It seems like you've had quite a day. Dad is just unbelievable. The second we get back to Roland, he says, I'll leave for the reporting to you, and takes off for home. The sheer nerve, I tell ya.
There's no need to make a mountain out of a molehill over it. At least the boys came back safe and sound. Anyway, I think that's all there is to report. Ding! So we got 3 BP here, which is very nice. And plus 1, because why not? So now, we're still 9th class.
You did well for your first assignment. From the details of your report alone, I believe I can commend you both for a job well done. You should be proud of yourselves. You really think so?
I know so. In fact, you'll do even better on your next job. If anything else comes up, I would appreciate your help again.
Sure.
How about we head home too?
I guess we better. I still got dinner to prepare. Would you mind holding on a second? A letter arrived for your father just a little while ago. Unfortunately, since he went straight home, I never got a chance to give it to him. Do you think you could deliver it instead? I wonder if it's more work-related stuff. I imagine so. The letter appears to be from one of our foreign branches.
One of the guild's foreign branches? As I'm sure you already know by now, Limbo isn't the only country where the Bracer Guild exists. On top of that, your father is widely known all across the Zemurian continent, so we can expect these kinds of letters from time to time.
If you two would be so kind as to make sure that he gets this letter, I would really appreciate it.
Anyway, there's no current job listings. Sweet. So, with that, I'm going to end the part off here. Thank you guys so very much for watching. Hopefully, you guys are a bit more interested in this game now that we're actually getting into gameplay-wise stuff. And with that, yeah, I'll see you kids next time. See you kids then. Bye-bye!